Welcome to the Ensure and SystemSure Plus tutorial for setting ATP pass-fail limits for the food and beverage industries. In this video, we will cover lower and upper RLU limits, default limits on your systems, how to determine custom limits, and how to program those limits. Let's get started. The first section is lower and upper RLU limits. Test results are measured in relative light units. RLUs are a unit of measure for adenosine triphosphate. The scale varies depending upon manufacturer, but the greater the amount of ATP, the greater the RLU number. Any RLU score less than the lowest threshold is a pass and will be indicated by a check mark on the screen. Pass results indicate that the location has been cleaned properly and it is safe to continue production. A score in between the pass and fail threshold is a caution and will be indicated by an exclamation point. Depending on your internal protocol, the caution location should either be re-cleaned and retested until a pass result is achieved, or monitored for future problems. A score greater than the upper threshold is a fail and will be marked with an X on the screen. A fail result indicates the surface is dirty or contaminated. The failed location should be immediately re-cleaned and retested until a pass or caution result is achieved. Your meter comes preset with a default lower limit of 10 and an upper limit of 30. This creates a caution area of 11 to 30. If you wish to eliminate the caution area, set 10 as your pass limit and 10 as your fail limit. The default limits of 10 and 30 RLUs are based on years of food and beverage processing experience and third-party studies. For more information, the ATP Thresholds technical document is available at hygiena.com. Download this document for your records or HACCP documentation. Hygiena encourages users to validate these recommendations and adjust them to meet the requirements of each facility's unique needs. The next section is determining custom RLU limits. In some cases, custom RLU limits may be required for certain locations. Programming custom RLU limits depends on the following factors. The first factor is the type of surface. Surfaces that are easy to clean, such as stainless steel or flat, non-porous surfaces, may have stricter, lower limits. Surfaces which are hard to clean, such as porous, grooved, creviced, or irregular surfaces like conveyor belts, may have higher limits. The next factor is direct contact versus indirect contact surfaces. Surfaces that do not have direct contact with high-risk products, such as a control button or the side of a conveyor belt, may allow less stringent RLU limits. On the other hand, surfaces that do have contact with high-risk products, such as raw meat, may require stricter RLU limits to ensure cleaning interventions are effective. The last factor is the type of product. Products with a lower risk of contamination, such as cooked products or products with a longer shelf life, can have higher RLU limits. On the other hand, products with a higher risk of contamination, such as ready-to-eat products and products with a short shelf life, may require lower RLU limits. To determine custom RLU limits for your facility, complete this four-step process. Identify, clean, test, and calculate. Step 1. Identify control points in the facility. These are often outlined in the GMP, SSOP, or HACCP programs. Step 2. Clean surfaces to the highest standard of cleanliness. This may include a total production line breakdown. Refer to your GMP, SSOP, or HACCP program for more information. Be sure that future cleanings will be held to this level of clean as a standard. Step 3. Perform an ATP test at each control point, taking 5 to 10 replicate tests. You can either perform tests over several days, or, for control points with large surface area, perform multiple tests from different spots at that location. Step 4. Calculate the lower and upper RLU limits. To calculate the lower RLU limit, take the average RLU for each location based on the 5 to 10 test results. The average result will be the lower RLU limit. To calculate the upper RLU limit, you can either multiply the lower limit by 3, or for the most statistically sound method, determine the standard deviation from the test results, multiply the standard deviation by 3, and add this to the lower limit. For written instructions and a spreadsheet, download the technical document entitled Establishing ATP Thresholds from hygiena.com. Or contact us for an Excel calculator. Now that you've established your custom limits, we will discuss programming those limits. You can manually adjust the pass-fail limits on the instrument through the menu option Programs. Or, to get the most out of your monitoring system and be able to run charts and graphs with your test results, then program your locations using SureTrend software and sync to your meter. Constantly looking to improve your food safety program shows due diligence and is crucial to finding trouble zones, correcting improper cleaning procedures, decreasing risk, and avoiding recalls. If you're obtaining high frequencies of caution and fail results, users should review sanitation materials and procedures. In some cases, if you rarely obtain caution or fail results, consider lowering your limits for a more strict program. This concludes our Hygiena tutorial. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on our newest videos. If you have any questions, feel free to contact Hygiena with the information on the screen. With 24/7 customer service and technical support, Hygiena is here to help.